Hey, good morning everyone, welcome to our channel. Today we're going to discuss about introduction to HTML, and it's a complete video. So it's a complete video about hypertext markup language, so you can find the entire HTML into a single video. Okay, so how we divide this? So starting from basics of HTML to the advanced HTML, so we'll walk through the process of how to define tags, what are the different attributes we have. So everything, every complete details of HTML is made in a single video. So definition, so we'll start with definitions here. So what is www? So as we know, www is World Wide Web. So coming to HTML, as we know the definition, right? So HTML is nothing but hypertext markup language. So what is this hypertext markup language? The language of web pages on the World Wide Web. So it is a language of web pages on the World Wide Web. So HTML is a text formatting language. And we should know some definition about URL. So URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. So coming to browser. So what is browser basically? So browser, a software program which is used to show web pages. So here my video is like, first this video gives the complete details about HTML with some basic examples of each and every topic. So after this video, I will do some other videos about programs, each program. For example, if we talk about HTML attributes, so I will do only programs about HTML attributes, and I will record that video as well. So executing in any editor, I will record that. And coming to our actual video here, so normal text surrounded by bracketed tags that tell browsers how to display web pages. So we'll write normal text, but it is surrounded by bracketed tags, so less than symbol or greater than symbol. So these are called bracketed tags. So what does they tell? They tell browsers how to display web pages. So what is the extension we need to save? So your pages ends with .htm or .html. Okay, so either way you can save your pages. So HTML editor. So how we execute this? So do we really need an editor? Or without an editor, can we execute our HTML programs? As we can write in a notepad, and we can save it using .htm or .html, and we can execute our program, and opening that in any browser, we can see our result. But it's better to have a HTML editor, so that makes our job very easy, right? So HTML, a word processor that has been specialized to make the writing of HTML documents more effortless. So there is nothing to put much effort if we have a HTML editor with us. So normally we'll write in Notepad, and we'll say that we'll save that into .html, .html, and finally we'll open that in any browser. So that's, it's a tedious job, right? So in order to get rid of that problem, so we'll download some HTML editors. So there are many online editors also available, so you can use either way. So end of the day, our job is to execute our web pages, isn't it? Next, coming to our concept, tags. So what are tags? So these codes enclosed in brackets. So as I said, bracketed tags, that is less than symbol or greater than symbol. If you see, usually paid between less than symbol or greater than symbol, and we have a forward slash for ending tag. So if you see title as an example, so title, my web page, and we're closing that title. So title is a starting tag, and title is also an ending tag. But what is the difference between starting tag and ending tag? So in ending tag we have a forward slash, right? So that makes difference here. So it's not case sensitive. Okay, so choosing text editor. So as I said, there are many text editors, right? So how effectively we choose our text editor? So there are many different programs that you can use to create web documents. So HTML editors enable users to create documents quickly and easily by pushing a few buttons. So instead of entering all of the HTML codes by hand, these programs will generate the HTML source code for you. So for example, generally we write doc type HTML, So doctor type HTML and we should have a boilerplate code. So these text editors mainly give some boilerplate code for us. So that makes our job easier. Okay. So starting Notepad. So generally we have a standard text editor that is Notepad, as we know. So there are many latest versions of Notepad as well. There is Notepad++ and all. So Notepad is a standard text editor that comes with the Microsoft Windows operating system. To start Notepad in Windows 9 or 10 or XP or whatever, click on the Start button located on your Windows taskbar. Click on the Programs and you can see Accessories over there and locate the shortcut Notepad and click the shortcut once. So HTML page creation and editing. So this is most important, right? So we should create an HTML page and we should be able to edit that HTML page. So here we'll discuss about how to create HTML pages with a standard text editor. So what basically the objective is, you should be able to choose a text editor, create a basic starting document, understand and set document properties, view the results in a browser. So creating a basic starting document. So if you see here, so first it starts with HTML and it ends with HTML. So as I said, there is a difference between starting tag and ending tag. So your starting tag is HTML and your ending tag is HTML. So as we know, the difference between starting tag and ending tag is, in ending tag we have a forward slash for differentiation purpose. Okay, so HTML tag, and we have a head section and body section. Okay, so what does head section hold? So head section mainly holds about your title information like that. So the title, you can write whatever title you want. So I'm opening title tag and I'm closing title tag, and head is closed and comes to body tag. So body tag is what which we display and what is to be displayed on the web page. Okay, so whatever you write, for example, you want to write your name. So write it in a H1 tag. So H1 tag is heading 1 tag. Okay. For example, this is Praveen. So if I write like that, H1 tags means the highest, the first heading tag, that is H1. So, and you can write H2, you can write paragraph tag, you can use whatever you want. So whatever you want to display, you write inside a body tag. So this is a creating a basic structure document. Okay. The head of your document point to above window part. The title of a document appears in the very top line of the user's browser. If the user chooses to bookmark your page or save as a favorite, it is the title that is added to the list. The text in your title should be as descriptive as possible, because this is what many search engines on the internet use for indexing your site. So if our site needs to be present on many search engines, so the effective way of writing is in the title. So our title should be as descriptive as possible. So setting document properties. So document properties are controlled by attributes of the body element. So if you want to set your document properties, so that's controlled by body element. For example, if there are color settings for background color of the page, the document text and different states of links. So what we do here, so we'll use this body attributes of body element and we'll set those settings. Color codes. So this is the most important thing. For example, if you want to set pink color, if you want to set orange color, if you want to set red color. So there are many color codes for each and every color. So whatever color code we choose for the basic colors, which we have is RGB colors, right? So within this range, we can find our different color codes. So there are many color codes and each color code has its own importance, right? So depending upon your requirement, you can choose whatever color code you want. So colors are set using RGB color codes, which are represented as hexadecimal values. So each two digit section of the code represents the amount in sequence of red, green or blue that forms the color. So it's a combination of red, green or blue that forms the color. For example, a RGB value with 00 as the first two digits has no red in the color. So that means the first one, so total for example, if two digits are there, right? So two digits for red, two digits for green, two digits for blue. Okay, so if the first two digits are zero, that means there is no red present in the color. So if this other two digits are zero, then there is no green. If the last two digits are zero, then there is no blue. So here color codes are most important part. So this is the main colors which we have. So red, green and blue, and it's a combo. So different combinations of these colors. So RGB color model, grayscale, white, red, magenta, blue. So it's a color model. So nothing to worry about. You can find different color codes. If you type color codes for HTML in Google, you may find different color codes. So these are the 16 basic color codes we have. This is for your reference. So aqua, black. So you can see the RGB triplet. So you can use direct values like that, 0, 255, 255. Or you can also use hexadecimal code, right? So 00FFFF like that. So here we have different colors we have. So depending upon our requirement and how our website should look, if I want to look, make my website more beautiful, you can use beautiful colors. So for that reason you should know the different color codes, right? So there are some basic examples here. If you want to white, you can use the hash FFFFFF. So it's for white. So you can also use the hash FFF. So no need to write 6 digits over there, you can write 3. So for black, all 6 zeros, hash 000000. For red, FF0000. For green, so as I said, you can see the 6 digits over there. For red, we should select those 2 digits FF. For green, other 2 digits FF. For blue, the last 2 digits FF. So remaining will become zeros. So magenta, C1, cyan, yellow, aquamarine. So there are many color codes present. So nothing to remember here. So you can directly search for color codes in Google so that you can get more color codes. Okay, there are many different color codes here. And coming to the most important element, that is body element. The body element of a web page is an important element in regards to the page appearance. So how your page should get appeared. So how beautiful your page should get appeared. So that totally depends upon the body element. So coming to head element, so you can write a title. So that's not that important, right? So how your page look like and what how your page appearance should look like. So everything depends upon your body element. So that's the important element. So here are the attributes of the body tag to control all the levels. So text equal to RRJGB to change the color of all the text on the page. Okay, so you can write text equal to some, you can use different color codes. This element contains information about the page's background color, the background image, as well as the text and link colors. So background color. It is very common to see web pages with their background colors set to white or some other colors. To set your document's background color, you need to edit the body element by adding BG color. So how to change the background color here? So we have an attribute called BG color. So BG is nothing but background. So BG color attribute we should use to change our background color. The following example will display a document with a white background. So what I wrote here, body BG color equal to hash. So we know color code for white is FFFFF. So if you want to use the color code for black, I will write hash 000000. And I close my body tag. So in this way, I will set my background color. So what's the attribute for that? So BG color. So if you want to change my text color, okay. So the text attribute is used to control the color of all the normal text in the document. The default color for text is black. The text attribute would be added as follows. So the default color for text is, so if you not specified anything, the default text color should be black. So body BG color equal to hash FFFFFF. So text equal to hash FF0000. And I close the body tag. So in this example, the document's page color is white and the text would be red. So link, v-link and a-link. So what is this link? These attributes controls the colors of the different link states. Okay, so link, link, its initial appearance. So default equal to blue. V-link, v-link stands for visited link. Okay, so default equal to purple. A link is nothing but active link being clicked. So if you want to click that link, so that's nothing but a link. Okay, so its default is yellow. So the formats for setting these attributes is, so in this way, body bg color equal to hash FFFFFF. So text equal to hash FF0000. Link equal to like that, vlink equal to alink equal to. So using image background. Okay, so the body element also gives the ability of setting an image as a document's background. An example of a background's image is body background equal to, I'll write hi.gif and bg color equal to hash FFFFFF and body. So using image background, so a background is set with the image which you, the link which you give here. So for example, if there is an image of a cat in hi.gif, so you can see background image as cat. So this is the starting document. So edit, save, what to preview, work, open web browser, to the following file, open. So it's nothing but whatever we did in order to check that. This is the process. The browse button, selected file, same document, the new revisions. Okay. So the next most important is headings, paragraphs, breaks, and horizontal rules. So this is a chapter wise topics, but I'm making it as a single video. So that's the reason, please watch till end of the video so you can find the complete details about HTML with examples. And anyways, I will also execute HTML programs and I will make that videos as well, but here you can find the complete details about HTML. Okay, so we'll use add headings, how to add headings to our page, insert paragraphs, add some breaks, and add some horizontal rules. So for example, if you want to complete our section, how should you be able to list and describe the different heading elements, use paragraphs to add text to your document, insert breaks where necessary, and adding a horizontal rule. So headings. So what are headings? For example, if you are writing in an answer sheet while writing our annual examinations or quarterly examinations, so in order to describe about any topic, first we'll give a heading of that topic as, right? So and we'll underline that heading so it looks good, and we'll come to know that it's a heading of that particular topic. So inside the body element, heading elements are 6, so h1 through h6 are generally used for major divisions of the document. So headings are permitted to appear in any order, but you will obtain the best results when your documents are displayed in a browser. So there are some guidelines to be followed here. So H1, the first heading is H1. H1 should be used as the highest level of heading, H2 as the next highest, and so forth. So you should not skip heading levels, and H3 should not appear after an H1. Okay, unless there is a H2 between them. So we should not skip the order. So let's see an example here, and you can see the output result as well. So HTML, and I close my HTML tag and head. I have written a title as example page. So you can write whatever title you want. So and I close my head tag and I open my body tag. So I have used all the 6 headings tags. So H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. So H1 heading 1, H2 heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, like that. So you can see the output. So you can see the difference here. So how heading 1 looks like and how heading 2 looks like. Heading 3, heading 4, heading 5, heading 6. Heading 6 is the last one, right? So in this way, we'll write headings, heading tags. And coming to the paragraph. So for example, if we remember, whenever we are set to write a paragraph about any particular topic, so we'll start and writing the paragraph. So if you want to describe in detail, we'll use a paragraph tag. So paragraphs allows you to add text to your document in such a way that it will automatically adjust the end of line to suit the window size of the browser in which it is being displayed. So each line of text will stretch the entire length of the window. So what happens in paragraph view? Each line of the text will stretch the entire length of the window. So this is one example of paragraphs. Okay, so anyways, I will execute these examples as in a separate video, but here what's the topic, what's the theory about that, and what is the example of each and every topic. So if we talk about headings, so we'll show an example here. If we talk about paragraphs, we'll show an example here, so that in that way it will be easier for you, right? So HTML and head and title here, example page, and body, inside body I wrote heading 1, and there I wrote paragraph 1. So next heading 2, after that paragraph P. So I opened my P tag and I closed my P tag. So in this way I can write example for paragraphs. So break. So what is break here? So if you want to break whatever line you want, that means you're writing something and you want to break that, so we can do that using line break. So it's nothing but a br tag. Line break allows us to decide when the text will break on a line or continue to end of the window. A br is an empty element, meaning that it may contain attributes but does not contain content. It may contain attributes but doesn't contain any content. The br element does not have a closing tag. So it is the thing which you need to remember here. So for paragraph, I have an opening tag and I have a closing tag. For HTML, I have an opening tag and I have a closing tag. Okay, for heading tag, I have an opening tag for H1, I have a closing tag for H1. But remember, there is no closing tag for break. Okay, and so this is an example here. So actually what I did, inside a body, I wrote heading 1 and after that I wrote a paragraph. So paragraph 1, and I have given break. So what happened? It came to the next line and I wrote line 2, line 3, and in between line 2 and line 3 I wrote break again. So what happened? It came to the next line. So in this way I can use break tag to break my line. Next, horizontal rule. So for this the tag is HR. The HR element causes the browser to display horizontal line in your document. So HR does not use a closing tag. Okay, so we don't have a closing tag as well for HR. Okay, HR attributes and descriptions, and what are the different attributes present in a HR tag? So we are saying that it's a line, right? So for that reason, we may require different attributes like size, width, align, color, all these, right? So we'll show a table here. So attribute size. So height of the rule in pixels. So the default value will be 2 pixels. Width. So width of the rule in pixels or percentage of screen width. Okay. So these are all attributes for HR, remember. So the width should be 100%. So 100% in the sense I'm talking about the default value. So no shade. Align. Aligns the line. Left, center, right. So whatever you want, you can align, but the default value is center. Color sets a color for the rule. Okay, so the default value is we have not set anything, any color for that. So in this way we have an example for horizontal rule here. So HTML, head, title, example page, body, H1 is heading 1, P paragraph 1, and I use break, and after line 2 I have used break. Okay, so I got into the next line, and after that I have used HR tag. You can see the line. Okay, so that's a horizontal rule. So you can give whatever attributes you want, which I have shown previously. So if you want to use size for that horizontal rule, you can use HR in bracket size equal to something like that. Next, character formatting. So how to change the color and size of a text. So for example, you are writing some text, so if you want to change the color of that text, or you want to increase the size of a text, so this is called character formatting. So use common character formatting elements, align your text, add special characters, use other character formatting elements. So the most important one is bold, italic, and there are many other character formatting elements. So let's see each one in detail. Okay, so font size equal to +2, that is 2 sizes bigger. Okay, and I closed font. So what I have done here, the size attribute can be set as an absolute value from 1 to 7. Okay, or as a relative value using the plus or minus sign. So if I use plus sign, That means it's an increase. If I use minus, it's a decrease. So normal text size is 3. That means from minus 2 to plus 4. Okay. So depending upon the what are the font size which we are selecting, so it can be in this way, either absolute value from 1 to 7, or it can be relative value using plus or minus sign. And I have bold. Okay. So if you want to make my statement into bold, so I will use bold tag here, B tag, that is bold, and I stands for italic, okay, and U stands for underline, okay, if you want to underline statement, okay. So the color attribute of the font element, font color equal to this text as color, and a font, this is a font tag, and I can use attribute called color, okay. So next important is pre. So pre is nothing but pre-formatted. So text enclosed by pre tags is displayed in a monospaced font. So what font it takes? It takes monospaced font. Spaces and line breaks are supported without additional elements or special characters. Next, emphasis. So emphasis tag is EM. So browsers usually display this as italics. So if you use emphasis browser, what does it do? It usually displays this as italics. And strong. So there is a bold tag, right? B, and there is strong tag as well. So both are same, but browsers display this as a bold. So it's better convention is to use strong instead of bold. Next, TT. So TT is nothing but teletype. Okay. So depending upon the requirement, we can use this or we can't. We will not use this. So text is displayed in a monospaced font, a typewriter text. Okay. So that is TT. Next, cite. So citation. So represent a document citation, but basically in italics. For titles of books, films, etc. Typically displayed in italics. So this is an example here. B font size equal to plus 1, one size larger, a font normal. Okay, a font size equal to minus 1, one size smaller. Okay, so you can see depending upon how the font size changes here, if it is plus 1, if it is minus 1, and bold. Okay, so bold, if I do I, that is italics, so you can see how it is turned into italics, and underline, so how we got underline, and colored, so color equal to FF0000 is nothing but red, right? So emphasized and strong, so you can see bold and strong both are same, but the best convention is to use strong. So teletype, so this is example for which we discussed right now. Okay. So alignment. So some elements have attributes for alignment. So we use align. So headings, paragraphs, and horizontal groups. So the three alignment values are left, right, center. So basically we have three alignment values: left, right, and center. So center will center elements. So we have center tag as well. What does it do? It will center elements. So div align equal to value. We'll close that div. Represent a division in the document. So what is it? What's the use of a div tag here? Represents a division in the document and can contain most other element type. The alignment attribute of the div element is well supported. So table. So inside a table, alignment can be set for each individual cell. So we can use this in table basically. So what we will do here? Inside a table, alignment can be set for each individual cell. So special characters and symbols. So these characters are recognized in HTML as they begin with an ampersand and end with the semicolon. So example, ampersand value. The value will either be an entity name or a standard ASCII character. So what is ASCII here? American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So they are called escape sequences. So this is special characters and symbols. Okay. So ampersand. ampersand greater than ampersand gt, that's greater than symbol, ampersand lowercase, that is asterisk, ampersand lt, that is less than, non-breaking space, that is NBSP. We'll use copyrights, right? So at the end of our footer tag, we'll use copyright, all rights reserved to, something like that, right? So for that we use ampersand copy, that is C, and we have a registration mark. So if you want the user registration mark, so we'll use ampersand reg. So somewhere we find a TM sign, that is trademark sign, right? So we use ampersand trade, okay? So these are all different special characters and symbols. So we can't directly use greater than symbol, right? So we use ampersand GD for greater than symbol. So what is the special character? What is the entity name which we are following? Okay, so additional escape sequences support tags and characters such as OUML, that is a lowercase o with an UML, and entile a lowercase with entile e grave. So these are all different special characters and symbols. So additional character formatting elements, so stripe. So stripe through text. Okay, so dil is used for stripe at the latest browser. So big places text in a big font, small places text in a small font. So if we use big, that places the text in a big font, small text in a small font. Sub places text in subscript position, sub places text in superscript style position. Okay, example, so P stripe, so strike through text. Okay, big places the text in a big font, so we use big. Small places text in a small font, sub. So okay, so coming to the most important one is lists. So here the list can be, for example, if you went to a grocery store, okay, so there may be many grocery items which we want to purchase. Okay, so for example, we should have a basic idea, right? For example, I want to buy milk products, so I should know what I need to purchase. So for that reason, I should have some list. Okay, so I will write on a piece of paper, first I need to buy this, second I need to buy this, and third I need to buy this, like that. So we should have a basic idea about what we should buy, right? So here comes our list. So that means we'll prepare one list, okay? So there are two ways we will prepare some list. For example, we have an ordered list, we have an unordered list. So what is the exact difference between ordered list, unordered list, and nested list, and defined list? So we'll see each one. So list elements. So here HTML supplies several list elements. So most list elements are composed of one or more li elements, that is list item elements. So unordered list. So unordered list, items in this list start with a list mark such as bullet. So you can see here in the last, you can see list item in a bullet symbol. Okay, for ordered list, we can see in number format, that is 1, 2, 3, like that, right? Okay, so browsers will usually change the list mark in nested list. So what is the tag for that? UL. Okay, and we have closing tag with UL. Okay, so inside UL we should write li tag, that is list. Okay, so for UL or OL, so UL is unordered list and OL is ordered list. So for both we'll use li tag as an example. Okay, so inside our UL tag or OL tag, so li is list, so list item. So we can see the bullets there. So you have the choice of three bullet types: disk, that is default, circle or square. Okay, so disk is default here, you can use circle or square. So we should specify the type. So if you write UL type equal to square, so we'll get like square. So if you not specified anything, you will get disk as a default. So if you type for UL type equal to circle, then we'll get circle. Okay, so next is ordered list. So items in this list are numbered automatically by the browser. So who is going to do that? We're not going to do that, browser is going to do that. So the tag for that is OL. So OL, and as I said, LI is common here. So OL, and I'm closing OL. You can see the numbering over there, 1, 2, and 3. So you have the choice of setting the type attribute to one of five numbering styles. Okay, so type 1, Arabic numbers, 1, 2, 3, A, lower alpha, A, B, C, capital A, upper alpha, capital A, capital B, capital C, I, that is lower Roman, capital I, that is upper Roman. So these are the numbering styles and different types we have. Okay, so you can specify list elements. You can specify a starting number for an ordered list. So OL type equal to I, that is starting list item. P text, OL type equal to I, start equal to 3. Okay, so you can see 1, 2, and text, and 3 list item. So that means we are specifying when it should start. Okay, so you can specify the starting number on ordered list only. So we can't do that for unordered list. Okay. So DL, definition list. So this kind of a list is different from the others. So each item in a DL consists of one or more definition terms. So we call it as DT elements, followed by one or more definition description. We call it as DD elements. So DT stands for definition terms. DD stands for definition description. So DL and enclosed DL, DT, HTML, DT, and DD. So you can see the difference here. HTML and hypertext markup language, that is definition, description, and DD. There, DD, that is definition, description, that means HTML. So you want to define what HTML is. So I will write under DD, that is you are defining that description. So HTML stands for hypertext markup language. So if you want to describe about dog, so it's a human's best friend. So like that, we'll use DL. So nesting list. So you can nest list by inserting a UL, OL, etc. inside a list element, a list item. So within the list elements, we'll include it. So UL type equal to square, LI list item, OL type equal to I, start equal to 3. Okay, list items, and again, so this is the nesting list, inserting inside the one list inside the other list. Okay, so this is an example for that. So what will be the output? H1 align equal to center, safety tips for the canvases, OL type equal to yes, start equal to, we should start with 2. It's an ordered list, so it should start with 2. Be able to swim, so it's a nested list. So you can write what is output present for that in my comment section. So list inside a list inside a list inside a list. So this is called a nested list. So this is the output for the previous one. So in this way we'll get the output here. So B, C, D. So because we're starting with 2, right? So there is one more exercise for you guys. So H1 align equal to center, safety tips for canvas, OL type equal to A, start equal to 2, LI be able to swim. So you can see so what I wrote here, and you can guess what's the output for that. So you can pause this video and you can write this one so that you can practice it, right? So you can check what output are you getting. So this is the output which we get for that previous slide. So next is most important thing is images. So how to display images in our web pages. So is it possible to display images in our web pages? So if that's so, what we should do. So what are the different objectives for this? So the first and foremost challenge is how to add images to our pages. So for that, we need an image tag. So image element. So this element defines a graphic image on the page. So if we use directly image tag, there is no use with that, right? So we should know source, where that image is located. Okay. How web pages take that image, you should know about the source, right? Okay, so which is called as image file, we call it as SRC, that is source. So this value will be a URL location. Okay, so you can see the example over there, some domain.com or directory file.exe extension. So that's the source. So, and there is one more element called alternate text, ALT. So this is a text field that describes an image or access a label. It's displayed when they position the cursor over a graphic image. So if we hover the cursor over that particular image, then it shows the alternative text. Okay. Next, alignment. So this allows you to align the image on your page. So you want your image to be on the left side, or if you want the image to be on the right side, or if you want the image on to be in between the center. So you should define using this alignment, that is align. Width. So width is the width of the image in pixels. And height. So height is the height of the image in pixels. Border. Border is for a border around the image specified in pixels. So border of the image, headspace. So and vSpace. So there are two spaces here, headspace and vSpace. So headspace stands for horizontal space and vSpace stands for vertical space. Horizontal space on both sides of the image specified in pixels. So a setting of 5 will put 5 pixels of invisible space on both sides of the image. So for the same thing for vSpace as well. So some examples on images. So image source equal to some jordan.gif border equal to 4. Okay, so image source equal to jordan.gif width equal to 60, height equal to 60. So I'm mentioning in between width 60 and height 60 my image should fit. So image source equal to jordan.gif alt equal to, this is the text that goes with the image. So I'm writing alternative text here. And image source equal to jordan.gif headspace equal to 30, vSpace equal to 10. So here I'm specifying horizontal space to be 30 pixels and vertical space to be 10 pixels, and I use a border of 20. So image source equal to jordan.gif ln equal to left. Okay. So anchors, URLs and image maps. So this is the most important tag, that is anchor tag and URLs and the image maps. So once we should get the basic idea about how to insert links into document. So I want to insert a link into document. So some people are visiting my website and they want to go to some particular page. So what I will do, I will provide a link for that particular page. Okay. So what happens, they will click that link and they will go to that particular page and define link type. So what sort of a link type we are providing, we should define that, right? So define URL, list some commonly used URLs and plan an image map. So we'll see. So how to make a link. So the link, the tags used to produce links are called anchor tags. So it's like capital A open and with a forward slash and we'll close the capital A. So this is anchor tag. So the A tag tells where the link should start and the forward slash A indicates where the link ends. So everything between these two will work as a link. So whatever we write in between the opening tag of A and closing tag of A, it works as a link. So the example below shows how to make the word here work as a link to Yahoo. So I'm using a word here. Okay. So I want that word here to act as a link for Yahoo.com. So what I will do? Anchor tag, and I will use an attribute href. So href is reference. Okay, so what I'm going to refer, okay, http www.yahoo.com to go to Yahoo. So what I will do, I will have a link of yahoo.com with the word here. So if I click that word here, then yahoo.com will open. So more on links, body link equal to V link equal to A link equal to, so link, that is standard link to appear the visitor has not been yet. So the standard color is blue. V link, visited link. So normal link stands for standard link and V link is visited link to a page that visitor has to be before. A link is an active link, the color of the link when the mouse is on it. Okay. So using this I can write an example on the links. So internal links. So links can also be created inside large documents to simplify navigation. So today's world wants to be able to get the information quickly. So I don't want to wait for more time, right? So what I will do, I want my information quickly. So I'll use this internal link. So internal links can help you meet these goals. So select some text at a place in the document that you would link, like to create a link to, then add an anchor to link to like this. So then A name equal to bookmark underscore name and close the anchor tag. The name attribute of an anchor element specifies a location in the document that we link to shortly. Okay. All name attributes in a document must be unique. And remember, all name attributes in a document should be unique. So next, select the text that you would like to create as a link to the location created above. So A href equal to hash bookmark underscore name. So go to bookmark. So next is email. Okay, so we have a habit of sending emails. Okay, so this type of service is identified as a mail client program. This type of link will launch the user's mail client. So what we'll do here, anchor tag a href equal to, we'll write mail to column some xyz@yahoo.com, send me more information. So if you click that, if you click under send me more information, then will be sent as a mail, email, electronic mail. So image maps. So image maps are images usually in GIF format, okay, that have been divided to regions. So click in a region of the image cause the web server to be connected to a new URL. Okay, so it's better to use image maps, and if you click that in a particular region, a URL is opened. So image maps are graphical form of creating links between pages. So there are two types of image maps, a client side and a server side. So both types of image maps involve a list of coordinates that define the mapping regions and which URLs those coordinates are associated with. So area shapes use. So we should know the coordinates over here. So rectangle, so what coordinates are there for rectangle, for circle and for polygon. So first we should find the coordinates. So client side image maps. Okay, so client side image maps use a map file that is part of the HTML document in an element called map and is linked to the image by the web browser. So image source equal to node.gif, width equal to 200, height equal to 200, border equal to 5. So map name equal to map1, area shape equal to RECT. So RECT stands for rectangle, and we'll specify the coordinates here. Okay, so area shape equal to rectangle, area shape equal to circle, area shape equal to poly. So all these are your client side image maps. So shapes and coordinates. So the types of shapes are RECT, that is rectangle, used for squares and ordered shapes, circle used for circuits, poly used for unordered shapes. So number of coordinations for each shape are rectangle, 4 number for 2 corners, circle 3 numbers for the center and R, poly depends on the number of corners of the shape. So and the most important one which we discussed now is tables. So how to insert a table inside our web page? Okay, so for example, let's take an educational website as an example. So if you want to display students information, for example, inside your educational website, there is a link for sports. So if you click that sports, and if you want to see the students who got prizes in cricket or who got prizes in football, for example, there are 10 students. So it's better to have a table of 10 students, okay, and having those details inside a table, it's a better way of a better approach, so that our website looks very good, right? So normally, how to insert a table, what are table attributes, how to edit a table, is a table header really needed? So all these we discuss now. So the table element has 4 sub elements. Okay, so table tag, so table element, out of this element, table element has 4 sub elements. Table rows, we call it as tr. Table header, we call it as th. Table data, we call it as td. Caption. Okay, the table row elements usually contain table header element or table data elements. Okay, so we will see an example here. So table border equal to 1. So if you don't specify border, then there will be no border for your table. So if you specify border equal to 1, so you can have your table with a border 1. Okay, so here we have tr. Okay, so inside a tr we have th and we also have td. Okay, so first we should define table headers. So the tag for that is th. Okay, so inside a tr I'll write th, the column 1 header and column 2 header. So after that I will close my tr and I will open tr again for td purpose. So td stands for table data. So td row 1 column 1, td row 1 column 2. Next again td. So that means I have a heading here, columns, and how many rows data I have here. So everything I will write in this format: table tr th and table tr close and tr td for data. So in this way I get my output: column 1 header, column 2 header, and those are 2 columns, and the data which we have is row 1 column 1, row 1 column 2, row 2 column 1, row 2 column 2. Okay, so the data which we represent in td and the header which we represent in th. So table attributes. So as I said, for table, there may be different attributes, right? So having a table without any color combinations, it's look odd, right? So having different color combinations or different attributes of table, that looks very better. So it will be pleasing for us, right? So BG color, the first attribute is BG color. So that is background colors in a table. So some browsers support background colors in a table. And width. So we can specify the table width as an absolute number of pixels or a percentage of the document width. So you can set the width for the table cell as well. Next, border. So you can choose a number of numerical value for the border width, which specifies the border pixel. So in the previous example, the table border equal to 1. Cell spacing. Cell spacing represents the space between the cells and is specified in pixels. So what's the use of cell spacing here? So cell spacing represents the space between cells. Cell padding. So cell padding is the space between the cell border and the cell content and is specified in pixels. Align. Tables can have left, right or center alignment. Okay. So previously for different elements we have checked this attribute align, right? So we have left, we have right, we have center. So for table also we have an attribute called align. Background. So background image will be the title. Table caption. So table caption allows you to specify a line of text that will appear centered above or below the table. So table border equal to 1, cell padding equal to 2, caption align equal to bottom. Okay. The caption element has one attribute align that can be either top or bottom below the table. Table header. So what's the use of table header? Table data cells are represented by the TD element. Cells can also be TH elements, which results in the contents of the table header cells. So basically it is centered and in bold text. So table data and table header attributes. So call span. So what is call span here? Columns specifies how many cell columns of the table this cell should span. Row span specify how many cell rows of the table this cell should span. Align. Cell data can have left, right or center alignment. We align, there is vertical align. Cell data can have top, middle or bottom alignment. Width, you can specify the width as an absolute number of pixels or a percentage of the document width. Height, you can specify the height as an absolute number of pixels or a percentage of the document height. So basic table code. So you can see an example here. Table border equal to 1, width equal to 50%. So I am shrinking my table width to 50%. So caption, H1 spare parts. So I'm writing a caption for my table. Okay. For example, results. So if you want to show results of students, so you can write results as a caption. So what a caption I wrote here, spare parts. Now next I should have a table header, right? So for that reason, I will open TR, that is table row, and TH stock number, description, list price. So stock number, description, list price are my table headers. Now for each stock number I should fill some data, for description I should fill some data, and for list price I should fill some data. So for that reason I should open tr tag again, and I will use td instead of th. So th is already over, which is table heading. Now I will use td, that is table data. Okay, so in this way we will get our table. So table data and table header attributes. So table border equal to 1, cell padding equal to 2. So tr TH column 1 header, and TRTD call span equal to 2, row 1 column 1 and row span. So I have used call span and row span. So this is the example for the previous one. So row span and call span. So column 1 header, column 2 header and row 1 column 1. And here I divided like 2. Okay, row 2 column 2, row 3 column 2 is divided into 2. So these are the things to be noted down. TH, TD and TR should always have end tags. Okay, remember TH, TD, TR should always have end tag. So a default table has no borders. Okay, so a default table, there is no need to specify any border. Okay, so by default a table is flush with the left margin. And remember, default table is always flushed in the left margin. So you can change using align. So this is an exercise for you guys. So what will be the output? So you can pause the video and you can
You can know the output, or by typing or checking in your system, you can check the output. So this is the output basically we get. Okay. Next important thing is frames. So frames are relatively new addition to the HTML standard. So it is basically first introduced in Netscape Navigator. So first we should create a frame based page. What is this frame? Let's talk about frames in a general sense. Let's talk about photo frame. Okay, so we have a photo with us, and we need to fit that photo inside a frame. So now it looks better, right? So instead of having a photo with us, it's better to keep that photo in a photo frame, which looks beautiful, right? So frames. So how frames are created? So what are frame sets? Okay, what are frame elements? So how targets are set? So a frame page is actually made up of multiple HTML pages. Remember, what is frame here? A framed page. So we call it as a framed page when it is made up of multiple HTML pages. There is one HTML document that describes how to break up the single browser window into multiple window panes. So each window pane is filled with a HTML document. For example, to make a framed page with a window pane on the left and one on the right requires three HTML pages. So doc1.html, doc2.html and frames.html. So in this way, we'll divide into single browser windows into two window panes. So like this, doc1.html, doc2.html, and I'll fit those two into a single frame. So in this diagram, you can clearly understand. So these two are fitted under a single HTML page. I call it as frames.html. So frame page architecture. So for this, I require a frame set. So a frame set element is placed in the HTML document before the body element. Remember, not inside the body element, before the body element. The frame set describes the amount of screen real given to each window pane by dividing the screen into rows or columns. The frame set will then contain frame elements, one per division. Okay. Because there is no body container, frame set pages can't have background images. So frame set doesn't have a body container. So it doesn't have background images. It doesn't have background colors as well. So this is a frame page architecture. So you can check it here. HTML, HTML and head, frame page, frame set columns equal to 23%, 77%. So what I am doing here? 77 plus 23 equal to 100. So I'm dividing into 23% and 77%. And frame source equal to doc1.html and doc2.html. So what I'm doing here, I am inserting those two frames under a single frame, that is frames.html. So the one frame, that is doc1.html, is fit under 23%, and the other frame should fit under 77%. So it's a graphical view of the document which I described here. So the frame name equal to left pane, source equal to doc1.html, and you can see the first frame is for 23% and the second frame is for 77%. So frame set container. The frame set element creates divisions in the browser window in a single direction. This allows you to define divisions as either rows or columns. So rows determines the size and number of rectangular rows within a frame set. They are set from top of the display area to the bottom. So what are the possible values here? We'll use absolute pixel units, a percentage of screen height. So in this way, so frame set calls equal to 200, 20%, like that we'll use. So creating a frames page. So calls. So determines the size and number of rectangular columns within a frame set. So they are set from left to right of the display area. So what are the different possible values we have here? Absolute pixel units, that is 480, 160. A percentage of a screen width, 75%, 25%. I am dividing my percentage of screen width. So proportional values using the asterisk. So you can also use proportional values using asterisk values. So creating a frames page, frames border, frames spacing, border and border color. So you can see that frame spacing. And escape exit border and border color attributes to color, control the color and spacing between frames. So frame, this element defines a single frame within a frame set. So if you want to define a single frame within a frame set, we should use frame element. There will be a frame element for each division created by the frame set element. This tag has the following attributes. Source required, as it provides the URL for the page that will be displayed in the frame. Name required for frames that will allow targeting by other HTML documents. So we can use area, anchor, area, page, and form tags as well. So margin width, margin height, scrolling. So margin width, optional attribute stated in pixels determines horizontal space between the frame contents and the frame's border. So what's the margin width and what's the margin height? Okay, so it's an optional attribute, but you can also specify that. Scrolling, displays the scroll bars in the frame. Possible values are S, No, Auto. Okay, so if we use S, it always displays scroll bars. So if you don't want to use scroll bars, we'll give No. If you use Auto, browser will decide based on the frame content. So by default, the scrolling is Auto. So No Resize. So it's an optional one. So prevents users from resizing the frame. So users can't resize the frame. By default, the user can stretch or shrink the frames displayed by selecting the frame's border by moving up, down, left, or right. So user has that privilege. But by using No Resize, user can't resize the frame. No frames. So you can also use no frames here. So frame set calls equal to 23.7%. Frame source equal to name left pane, no frame. This is a framed page. Upgrade your browser to support frames. No frames. Now compound frame set divisions. So these are all a second frame set element will be inserted in the place of a frame element that would describe the second row. The second frame set element will divide the remaining screen real estate into two columns. This nested frame set will then be followed by two frame elements. So these are all nested divisions. So how frame sets are divided. So this is a compound frame set divisions. HTML head, compound frame, frames page, frame set rows equal to 120 comma star. That asterisk defines your percentage. Frame source equal to, I do the source over there. Frame set columns equal to. So this is the output of the combination of rows and columns, which we see suggest now, a links file, content file, and banner file. So this is a perfect example of frame set. So this is an example for compound frame set division example. So you can pause the video and you can note it down. So this is the output for that. So this is another output with the frame set rows equal to 50%. So you can see, rows. So you can see two rows with exact 50%, 50%. And this is for columns. So 50% and 50%. This is the frames. So this is rows 50-50, columns 50-50. Okay. So frame formatting. This is an example of frame formatting. You can pause the video and you can note it down. So this is example. See, this is an example for that. So you can see how frames are generated. Okay, frame set columns. So what are the space allocation priority? So this is the questions which we pose to ourselves. What is the frame set calls equal to 2*, 3*, 5*? So is there any difference for that? So what are the different percentage values here? Okay, how it is aligned from left to right? So we should have our own questions. The frame tag has 6 associated attributes: source, name, margin width, margin height, scrolling, no resets. So here is a complete generic frame. So frame source, name. So you can see all the 6 associated attributes in a single example: source, name, scrolling, margin width, margin height, and no resize. So what will be the output for this? So you can try on your own. Targets. So whether it goes to right or left, so we can specify our targets. So special targets. So if target equal to top, so this loads the link document to the full browser window with the URL specified by the here href attribute. So it shows in the top. Blank underscore blank opens an unnamed new browser window and loads the document specified in the URL. Target underscore self loads the document in the same window where the anchor was clicked. When the anchor is clicked, it opens in the same window. If you give target equal to self, target equal to underscore parent. The parent frame is a prior frame set that the current frame set was spawned from. So if a frame contains a following link, then clicking the link launches a new unnamed browser. So see there, all the four are defined here. Target equal to underscore blank, target equal to underscore self, target equal to underscore parent, target equal to underscore top. So if you use blank, if a frame contains the following link, then clicking the link, then clicking the link will simply cause the frame which contains the link to clear, and its content will be replaced with whatever is in stub. So these are different examples for self, for parent. Okay, for bottom, these are different examples for frames for bottom. And here comes to the most important concept in HTML, forms. Okay, what are forms? So for example, if you go for a bank and if you want to open an account, so there will be one form. So you should fill that form and submit to that bank guy so that your account will be open. Okay, and for example, if you want to fill any job application, so it's a form. Okay, so what are forms? So forms, so how these forms are helpful in our web pages. So how to represent these forms in our web pages? So forms add the ability to web pages to not only provide the person viewing the document with dynamic information, but also to obtain information of the person viewing it and process the information. So what is the agenda here? How to create a form? How to add elements to a form? So what is common gateway interface? What is CGI application? How to specify an action for the form? So what is specifying the action for the form? So having a form is not that important, right? So whenever we click that submit button, so what action does it follow? So what are we getting here? That counts, right? So having a form and clicking submit button doesn't make any sense until unless it has some action into it, right? So forms work in all browsers. So for example, some elements works in only few browsers, but forms will work in all the browsers. So forms are platform independent. This is the most important point here. So to insert a form, we use form and open tag for form and close tag for form. The rest of the form elements must be inserted in between the form tags. So HTML, head, title, sample, form, head, body, bg, color, equal to, I have specified some background color. Now comes our form. So form action equal to, okay, and first name, input type equal to text, name equal to fname, max is equal to 50. I have written in paragraph, and again input type equal to submit, name equal to f submit, value equal to send info, and I have closed form. Form element attributes. So what are the different attributes we have in form? Action is the URL of the CGI, that is common gateway interface program, that is going to accept the data from the form, processes it, and send a response back to the browser. So what is common gateway interface? The most important point to remember, it's a program that is going to accept the data from the form. For example, I have filled some details in the form and I have clicked submit button. Now what happens? So that data should get processed and sends a response back to the browser. Now, in order to get or post depends upon the method. Okay, so get, default method is get. So what data are we getting here? Browser is getting. Or post, post specify which HTTP method will be used to send the form's content to the web server. So a form has some details, right? So name, F name, L name, age, okay, skills. So for example, all this data is there, and if you click submit button, so this form's contents should go to the web server. So who is going to do that? So HTTP method post specify how to send the data to the web server. The CGI application should be written to accept the data from either method. So you can use get method or post method. By default, the method is get. Name is a form name. Target is the target frame where the response page will show. So form elements. So form elements have different properties here. Text boxes, password boxes, check boxes, radio buttons, submit, reset, file, hidden, and image. Okay. So there are different properties in a form. Okay. So it's our requirement how to beautify our form. So there may be no use of image in our form. So depending upon the requirement, depending upon the website we design, so depending upon the client requirement, we may design our form. But these are the different properties we have: text boxes, password boxes, check boxes, radio buttons, submit buttons. All these are different properties. The properties are specified in the type attributes of the HTML element input. And remember, where these properties are specified, these properties are basically specified inside the input element. So like this, name, student number, some university, city, mail, and finally we have a submit button. So we have a submit button, we have a radio button, we have drop down list. Okay, so this is a typical basic example of a form. So we have submit button here. So the major point is, once we submit it, what happens to that data, how it is represented finally. So that we'll see. What are the form elements? The first element is input. So type of the input entry field: name, variable name passed to the CGI application. Okay, value, the data associated with the variable name to be passed to the CGI application. Check, button or box checked. Size, number of visible characters in the text field. Max length, maximum number of characters accepted. So these are the input element properties. So these all properties are of input element. So text boxes, so you can see the example here, used to provide the input fields for text, phone numbers, dates, etc. So input type equal to text. So browser will display text box uses the following attributes: type equal to text, size default 20 characters, max length determines the maximum number of characters that the field will accept, name is the name of the variable to be sent to the CGI application, value will display its content as a default value. So this is a text box. So example on text box, so you can pause the video and you can check it. So title, head, body, inside a body we wrote form and we close form, and first name, last name, nationality, and we use the input tag, and what properties are we using, what attributes are we using. So you can pause the video and you can check. And this is the output which I get. Please enter the following biodata: first name, last name, nationality, like that. Password. So this is the most important one, used to allow entry of passwords. So how to get that password? So we should specify input type equal to password. So whatever we type, it is filled with asterisk. Okay. So browser will display text typed in the password is stayed out in the browser display. Password boxes use the following attributes: type, size, max length, name, value. So value is usually blank. So example on password box. So you can pause the video. So this is an example for password box. This is the output. To access, please enter username and password, like that. Hidden. Used to send data to the CGI application that you don't want the website for to see, change, or have to enter, but it is necessary for the application to process the form correctly. So input type equal to hidden. So nothing is displayed in the browser. So if you write input type equal to hidden, so we can't see anything in the browser. So hidden inputs have the following attributes: type, which is obviously hidden, name is the name of the variable to be sent to the CGI application, value is usually set a value expected by the CGI application. Checkbox. So checkboxes allow the users to select more than one option. So what is it? Input type equal to checkbox. So how browser will display? Checkboxes have the following attributes: type equal to checkbox, checked, it means whether it is checked or whether it is blank. So if we check attribute is checked initially, that means defaultly it is checked. Name is the name of the variable to be sent to the CGI application. Value is usually set to a value. So this is an example for a checkbox. You can pause the video and you can note it down. So this is the output. Please check one of the following: select country, select language, like that. Radio button. So radio button allows the user to select only one option, input type equal to radio. Browser will display as a following, browser will display in this format, and this is the following attributes: type is radio, checked is blank or checked as initial status, and name is the name of the variable to be sent to the CJ application. Value usually has a set value. So this is an example for radio button. You can pause the video and you can note it down. So this is the output for that. Okay, so this is one more example. So this is output, form 1, form 2, choices. Push button. This element would be used with the JavaScript to cause an action to take place. Okay, so input type equal to button. So browser will display like this. Push button has the following attributes: type, name, value. So type is button, name is the name of the button to be used. Value determines the text label on the button. So this is an example for that. You can pause the video and you can. And this is an output. Press here to see a baby crying. Click here to see a baby shouting. So click here to see a baby eating. So this is a button. So if you press that, you can see the action. So submit button. So every set of form tag requires a submit button. This is the element causes the browser to send the names and values of the other elements to the CJ application specified by the action attribute of the form element. So input type equal to submit. So if you write input type equal to submit, then the browser will display in this manner submit query like that. You can specify any name you want. The browser this submit has the following attributes: type, name, value used by the CJ script for processing, value determines the text label on the button. Usually default value is submit query. So this is an example for that, and you can pause the video and you can check it. And this is the output, first name, family name, like that. Then press here to submit the data. Reset button. So it is a good idea to include one of those for each form where users are entering data. It allows the server to clear all the input in the form. So submit, and we also have reset as well, right? So input type equal to reset. So browser will display in this manner, and it has the following attributes like type, value. And this is an example for that, and you can pause the video and you can check it. And this is the output for that, submit data, and we have a reset as well. So image submit button. So allows you to substitute an image for the standard submit button. So input type equal to something, so source equal to image submit button has the following attributes: type, name, source. So this is an example. You can map is there, you can click that map, so that it's nothing but submitting. File. So file upload. You can use a file upload to allow servers to upload files to your web server. So input type equal to file. So if you click browse like that, so browser will display. So file upload has the following attributes: type, size, name, max length. So your type is file, what is the size of the text box, name is the name of the variable to be sent to the CJ application, and max length. So this is example for this, and you can pause the video and you can note it down. And this is the output. Other elements used in the form: a text area. So for example, if you visit any website and if you have a contact us page there, they will ask you to share the feedback or submit any details. So there you can find this text area, so you can write any paragraph you want. It's an element that allows for free form text entry. So what attributes does it have? Name, rows and columns. So this is an example for that. You can pause the video. So this is the output. The wrap attribute. So normally text type in the text area by the user is transmitted to the server exactly as type, with the lines broken only when the user press the enter key. So wrap equal to off, wrap is equal to virtual, wrap equal to physical. Okay. The text area will contain one line, and the user will have to scroll to the right to see all of the text. One line of text will be transmitted to the server. Wrap equal to virtual, the text area will contain two lines of text broken after the word makes. only one line of the text will be transmitted to the server, like that. Other elements used in form are a select, where the elements are set differently. The select element attributes are name, size, multiple. So this is example for select. Select name equal to list, size equal to 5. So we have different options like London, Tokyo, Paris, New York. So here we can set our options. So this is output. Select the cities you have visited, like that. Other elements used in forms are drop down lists. Is the name of the variable to be sent? There are two different attributes here, name and size. So in the list box we have item 1, item 2. There is another form element used in the form list box. So the attributes which it has is name and size. Option. The list items are added to the select elements by inserting option. The option elements attributes are selected. So whether default it is selected or not, and what is the value for that. When this attribute is present, the option is selected when the document is initially loaded. Okay, so this is example for different computer types like IBM, Intel, Apple, Compaq. So you can pause the video and you can check it. And this is the output which we get. So this is another example. Okay. So there are 11 different types of form elements like button. So you can see it in here. In this single image, button, checkbox, file upload, hidden which we can't see, password, radio button, reset object, select object, submit object, text and text area. Okay, so this is basic details about the complete HTML which I covered in a single video. Okay, so for every topic basically I covered with an example. So it's better to pause the video and check the example, and you can note it down, you can execute in your system. Okay, so after this video I will create videos for each and every topic programs by executing in a editor, and I will show the output as well. So but this is a basical like a theory and practical in a single video, the complete HTML in the single video. I hope you like this video, and the people who are watching my channel for the first time, I request everyone to please subscribe my channel and please share my videos, and please inform about our channel to your friends and well-wishers, and please make them subscribe to our channel. So you will get more interesting videos like this, and please support us in all ways. So I request everyone to please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful day.